You know, you have people that think they have time. So they left away. They went away from the commandments and the teachings. That's why Jesus told Peter about the commandments. Keep my commandments. Feed my sheep. You know, but where? See, that's why God said, Jesus said, my Father's house shall be called house of prayer for all people. House of prayer is a special place. This is God's house where he put his name, where he said, I will hear your cry. I will hear your supplications here. I will relieve the oppressor off of you because I have somebody there waiting for you. He got it fixed up that way. And you can't turn the Bible around for man to make it fit their way. That's why hell have enlarged itself, because many people want to go. Because they don't want to obey the rule of God. Well, if somebody say, I got a word, I don't have to listen to this, and I had to. So they misinterpret the Bible, which you're not going to. How can you help somebody when you ain't born again yourself? So that's why all this had came to pass in here. But he answered and said, verily, which is truly, I say unto you, I know you not. Watch therefore, for ye know neither the day nor the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh. That's in the 25th chapter of Saint Matthew. And when you really pray and see what's going on, every passage that Jesus was talking about the kingdom, he had left out. He did these things and he brought in the people into the house of prayer and performed these miracles inside. When you go through these four gospels and really ask God to open up your eyes and pray and open up your understanding, and you'll know that when he was calling the sheep, that's why he say, my sheep will hear my call. So that's why signs and visions fulfilled is fixed up, because the sheep gonna hear his call. He said there come a time that there should be some that shall return unto him in the house of God. He also spoke of the glad tidings of the kingdom in St. Luke, the 8th chapter. You'll be going through that when you study that in the 8th chapter. He spoke of the purpose of the parables, but then he also spoke of the mystery of the mystery. That's why he said in certain parts, he said, and other fell on good ground and sprung up and bear fruit of 100-fold. And we had said these things, he cried, he that have ears to hear, let him hear. Listen, is what he's saying. And his disciples asked him, saying, what might this parable be? They questioned it. And he said unto you, it is given to know the mysteries of the kingdom of God, but to others in parables, that seeing they might not see, and hearing they might not understand. So sometimes God don't let you understand till he's ready to let you understand. So somebody has to bring you that understanding, and it's done by his word through power. That's what it's done by. Now the parable is this: the seed is the word of God, and those by the wayside are they that hear. Then cometh the devil. Don't you go in that place. That's what the devil. Don't you go there. They worship another god. They believe in a man. They believe in this. They believe in that. But not knowing that God have a man there that have that power that Jesus carried. He not gonna send somebody to us that's less. Because we still have the devil in the world, because he been cast down from heaven to the earth. So we have to deal with him. So that man that sits on the throne is not God, neither is he Jesus, but he's Jesus' preacher. God's mouthpiece. From Genesis to Revelation, God used a man to sit upon his throne. And one man at a time did he use. Yes, he did. As he told Moses. When God put Moses and his brother Aaron and Miriam, he put them in charge of everything. He said, y'all bless the people. And then they didn't want to hear Moses.